Good evening, Capitol Rivers Church. It is great to be together for this church-wide midweek service. I miss you guys. I miss being together, and I know that we all miss it as well. And, you know, for this church-wide midweek, we're trying to do something a little bit different. So what we've done is we've taken small groups from the East and paired them up with the West, mixed in some campus, some teens, to try to find some way to connect and be a bit more intimate. But before we get started with our midweek, Casey Burkett from the Campus Ministry has a fun icebreaker for us so that we can connect with one another. Casey Burkett, I turn it over to you.
Thanks, Phil. So our game tonight is a version of Apples to Apples. If you've never played it, I'll explain it, so don't worry. So there's a person who is in charge, who's in your group. They will message you a private message of a set of three nouns. As an example, my nouns will be Super Bowl commercials, blue shots, retirement. And so with these three kind of sitting in my Zoom chat box there, there's a person who will be selected to be it. The way we will decide who this person is you can debate amongst yourself after this, who has not left their house in the longest amount of time. They will be it, because they need some excitement in their life. And so once you get those things, I'll cycle through. So let's say my friend Kelly here is it, and she's got the adjective of profound. If these are the three that I have to work with, knowing what I know of Kelly, I'm going to pick which one I think will most likely have her pick me out of everyone else in the group. I would go with flu shots, given the time. Would you pick me?
Yeah, I'd pick you.
Excellent. I would win! But of course, you'd have however many people in your groups in their inbox. So you can do all that through the chat in the Zoom box, do private messages so no one else can see. And again, once my friend Kelly here had gotten everyone's submission, you check around, anyone else? Then you read them all out loud so everyone in the group can be like, oh, ha, 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 why on earth would she pick retirement? That's crazy. And then they'll go ahead and pick their favorite, the winner. So that's how you play. We'll go ahead and we'll set a timer after this so that you guys can kind of rifle through them and play the game. If you make it through the first round, so the first round's adjective, apocalyptic, seems fitting. If you have time for a second round, feel free to do so with the remaining two words that you have. That word would be for heavenly. So have fun, play the game, hopefully it's fun, and come back here and we'll keep midweekin'. See you guys.
I hope you enjoyed that icebreaker. Thanks, Casey. I'm really excited about this midweek. As we approach 7 weeks of staying at home, the need for encouragement is at an all-time premium. I know for me, if I'm honest, it has been really hard to stay at a distance, to see friends and have masks on and give virtual hugs, even being limited to only seeing people on the screen. And while these are certainly small challenges compared to what other people are facing, they are pretty real. I know that research shows that we need the human connection, touch, and I miss the face-to-face contact, the ability to be able to like touch my friend while I'm laughing and we're talking together. When I think about in my world, I probably give and get at least 5 to 10 hugs in a day. And that's not just from Phil. And so just being able to have the words of encouragement, it's just priceless. And I'm excited about this time that we're going to be able to share today.
Thanks so much, Ayana. You know, we all need encouragement. You know I need encouragement. And probably if you're sitting home right now, you can raise your hand. You probably need encouragement as well. You know, there's nothing like someone sharing the right word or giving you the right response at the exact right time that makes such a huge difference in our lives. You know, the Bible talks in the book of Proverbs about how powerful our words are. In Proverbs chapter 12 and verse 25, the Bible says, anxiety weighs down the heart, but a kind word cheers it up. Isn't that amazing? In Proverbs chapter 15, verse 4, it says, the soothing tongue is a tree of life, but a perverse tongue, it crushes the spirit. So powerful our words. In Proverbs 16, verse 25, here's a good memory verse. It says, gracious words are a honeycomb, sweet to the soul and healing to the bones. A timely word at the right time makes such a huge difference in our lives. Words are so important. Words have real power. They have so much power. Even the writer of the book of James, James says, he warns us that although the tongue is a small part of the whole body, it has the power to determine the whole course of our human existence. Words are so powerful. Today, brothers and sisters, what we need constantly are words of encouragement to help us to stay faithful and strong during these uncertain times. Over in the book of Hebrews in chapter 10 and verse 24, the Bible reads this. And let us consider how we may spur one another on toward love and good deeds, not giving up meeting together as some are in the habit of doing, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching. The writer here in the book of Hebrews uses the word encouragement. And this word of encouragement, it means to stir up. It means to provoke, to incite people in a given direction. You know, this verbal encouragement, it paints this idea of two people joining each other on this journey, and one person speaking words of encouragement that encourages the traveler to keep pressing on despite obstacles and fatigue. And in the spiritual life, we need one another and encouraging words. Sometimes there's spiritual fatigue. We need the encouragement to keep going when we don't want to go anymore. You know, have you ever been to a race before or to a track meet? You know, at some point, the runners, they're running around the last, you know, kind of the last leg of the race. And as they're running around, sometimes they hit this point where their bodies reach this limit. They start to cramp up. They start to tighten up. And there's something in them that says, I want to give up. But sometimes right in that moment, in that last leg, you'll see a coach or a parent or a teammate or a friend. They'll come out and they'll start screaming, come on, it's only a few yards. Push it, kick your legs, you can do it. And then you'll see the athlete, they'll hear the words and they'll turn and they'll kind of get this grimace with determination. They'll narrow their eyes. They'll start pumping their legs with this renewed strength until they finish the line. And it's amazing, just a timely word at the right time makes such a huge difference. I've never heard of been to a race or heard of a coach or a teammate or a father as their son or the person is running the last leg. I've never heard them say, you look tired. Why don't you just quit? You're in the back third of the field for a reason. Maybe running is not your sport. No, we don't hear that. And if you do hear that, shame on them. But you know, as Christians, we need encouragement. We need not just encouragement from the Word of God. We need it from the Holy Spirit. But the Bible says here in Hebrews to encourage one another. And sometimes it's not even just finishing the Christian race. Sometimes we need encouragement just to finish the day. A timely word or right response at the right time makes such a huge difference. The Bible says in Colossians chapter 3, verse 16, let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. You know, this evening, we're going to take some time to encouraging one another. And to explain it, I turn you back over to my lovely wife, and she'll explain what we're going to do during this time together. Ayana.
Thanks, Phil, for giving us that direction. Now let's practice. As you gather in your small groups, you'll have an opportunity to share a scripture, a song, or a word of encouragement that you have received that perhaps has refreshed your soul, has put a smile on your face, or encouraged you throughout the day. I know for me, it has been super encouraging just to hear LaTanya, my sister, blast holy water so that now I have a favorite song. I have received numerous scriptures. One of them in Deuteronomy just spoke of God flying through heaven and helping us. And it was so encouraging just to be reminded of what God is doing during this time. I do hope that as you spend time encouraging one another, that you too feel refreshed in your soul and have a smile on your face.
Do to my sign?
I wrote the same, but in different words.
Thanks, love.